Odysseus.
Odysseus.
King of the gods.
A ruler wise and just.
Odysseus.
Mighty warrior.
Who could crush his foes to dust.
Odysseus of the ancient bow. Carved from a sturdy limb. The only man who could bend the bow.
Famous and not just for beauty. She was patient and clever and strong of heart. She always did her duty.
Odysseus was called away to war in a kingdom across the sea. He promised his wife he'd soon return, but alas, it was not to be. The story of his voyage home is the story we're here to tell.
A story we sung for thousands of years.
A story we know quite well.
Monster!
Enchantment!
Tempest and shipwreck!
Every day a new test for Ithaca's king.
But Penelope always knew he'd come back.
To pick up his bow and make it sing.
Never knew new lecture be so good.
Bonus groups, why have you been on my life?
Yeah.
What are you doing? This is supposed to be a short stop. Come back to the book.
The Trojan War was 10 years of hard fighting. We've earned a little R&R.
Yeah. No, we have to get back to Ithaca. We still have a long way to go.
That Odysseus would get home.
them on. They rode until the sun had set and rode again at dawn.
Nobody.
Nobody is my name. Here, have another. Man of action, seven cities, and I'm not afraid of a one-eyed glutton or a swampy old father either. That's right, Poseidon. You heard me. You're all wet. Both of you.
Odysseus, you said. Odysseus, you won't get away with this.
He shouted out his name, for no Poseidon had no doubt Odysseus was to blame.
The gods do not look kindly on a man inclined to boast, and when it came to pride, Odysseus had the most.
Hear me, Odysseus. I, Poseidon, god esteem. Because of what you've done, your journey will be cursed. For 10 years, I'll send you raging storms. Scheming sorceresses and bloodthirsty monsters. Good luck getting home to Ithaca.
Poseidon roared in anger as Odysseus fled the scene. The crew took up their oars and turned the water like a machine.
But the eagles and with fishes here on the wide dark sea.
Like a shipwrecked sailor fighting for his life, I can't relax till I'm back on my home turf.
Back in Ithaca with Penelope, my wife. I can't be distracted by sun and surf.
What's in the bag? Some treasure, I bet. I did my part and I deserve my share. If he's been holding out, it's gonna stop tonight. It isn't right, it just isn't fair. Let's have a look. What was that? I'll try again. Seems to be under some strange kind of spell. But if Odysseus thinks he's gonna set aside the best of all the treasure for himself, then he can.
Oh.
true.
Chains never hurt anybody.
You're not going to turn them into wolves.
Hard.
Tigers?
You think you're so strong. You think you're so smart. You turn up your nose in my plums and my figs. But there's no way you're leaving this island. Because I'm turning your crew to pigs! You're not going anywhere. Not for a year at least.
Four seasons on this island sounds pretty good to me. We've been away forever. What's another year? Often the man who wins is the man who can persevere. So keep your chin up, keep your snout clean, keep your tail curled tight. And if you should meet a sorceress, better meet the light. There's no sweeter season than the summertime, with so many scraps for the taking. I'll happily finish your burger with cheese, but please hold the bacon. I love a good hash of summertime trash. It's so refreshing and nutritious.
2 weeks old and covered with mold. It's so delicious.
When folks go fishing with a bucket of bait,
cause there's nothing to tickle the tongue like the taste of a crispy, crunchy crickhead.
And keep your chin up, keep your snout clean, keep your tail curled tight. And if you're looking for a handout, better be polite.
Summer's okay, but I love the fall with a
rotten pumpkin.
Winter's twice as good, at least with a fine and fragrant turkey feast, but you can keep the legs at rest.
I'll take the liver.
Smarting the Cyclops was fun. Life is thirsty, turned out to be pretty good after all. But this siren song should really be sung.
Flashing through the waves, raises the sails, no more pigtails. Flash, we bravely make our way through the wild and windy sea. Crash, we and not look back as we continue on our spree.
What are we going to do about those sirens?
I'm going to stuff toilet paper in my ears.
thing around my ears.
Can you hear me?
Darn it.
You're gonna put this gum in my ear.
That's disgusting.
I also have this box of wax.
Can you hear me?
Odysseus can resist the sirens, but I have a plan. Odysseus made a sigh, but steam inside he had to sense that dangers were not
and his crew. What a trip!
Yes, it was a maggot.
Don't you think we should review before we move forward?
But I'm not sure we have time.
Don't worry, I can pick up the pace. When Odysseus went to war on the side of the Greeks, he expected to be gone at best a few weeks, but the war took longer than anyone expected. By the time the Greeks won and collected all the treasure, 10 years had passed. That's right, 10 years, so our hero was motivated to get home fast.
He rode on
through the wine dark sea. Though he got some friendly winds and clean sailor went in freedom, so his boat was badly battered, and his crew was sadly scattered by some madly wretched weather. But he gathered them together and said, "It doesn't matter, we have to get home.
Go, 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 go."
It took a while with Circe, little pennies out of mercy, but it wasn't too unpleasant, cause she kept them well fed.
It doesn't matter, we have to get home. Go, 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 go.
Was out of earshot of the sirens, thrilling, thrilling. They were getting pretty tired, but they couldn't let up because Poseidon kept up that run of that luck. A six-headed monster got the crew, looked delicious, so she set her sights on six of them, snatched them up like fishes, and Odysseus was too sick about it.
It doesn't matter, we have to get home. Go, 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 go,
go, go,
go, go, go, go, go, go.
They were tired, they were rattled, not to mention kind of famished. Then they spied a little island full of fat and happy cattle and began to applaud. But Odysseus wasn't easy, because the herds belonged to Helios, who happened to be a god.
And we all know what happens when you make a god angry.
Odysseus made him vow not to touch a single cow, but they slaughtered many cow. He was vexed, but they protested, "Hey, we're dying for some steak." It turns out they weren't lying, because when you steal from a god, it's going to be your last meal. Helios raised a storm to get some revenge. Odysseus survived, but he lost all his friends. Just like that, agreed to help them, launched the boat and heaved the oars, never slowing, never stopping, till they reached the rocky shores of Ithaca.
Yes, Ithaca.
For 20 years he dreamed of the day he'd return in triumph to claim his throne.
Now his fleet was wrecked, his crew all dead.
Odysseus was alone.
Stir.
lot has changed in 20 years. You will need to be careful. Don't tell anyone who you are. Yet, I will let you know when it's time.
Are you really gonna wait forever?
Stranger find hospitality here?
Hey, get out of here, we're much too busy. We don't want to hear a beggar whine. And you're smelling up the air around us.
No, it can't be.
Go sleep among the swine.
Can this really be Ithaca, a kingdom once known for its great hospitality?
Times have changed. Enough for ourselves.
What of the great bow of Odysseus? That priceless weapon?
It's worthless, uninsurable. A bow is no good if you can't string it.
They say none can string the bow, but Odysseus.
Heart is full of shame.
Shame.